I'm dealing with the distraction right now. I have a mental fortitude.
Ah, sir, you're here. The 7 kites you asked for have been made to order. Would you like to take them now?
Yes, thank you.
It's rare to see customers who want to buy this type of kite nowadays. In the early days, we used to get orders from people of all walks of life.
Well, this is Mr. Zhang Li from the Wangxiang Funeral Parlor, so he's probably well-versed in all these walks of life. We've talked about a whole bunch of things while traveling with him. He seems to know Liyue's favorite topics, money and government, really well, but he likes talking about less useful topics instead.
Well, that's because I prefer to share fun things with you.
Children's toys are very fun things, that's for sure. I enjoy watching the children at play as much as anyone else, but there is more to it than that. Finely crafted toys are well loved by children, but this craft itself has been honed over thousands of years, and there is meaning behind that. I have made kites in Liyue for 40 years, and I am intimately familiar with the forms passed down from my ancestors. The meaning of these 7 kites is far from banal.
Indeed. These are decorations used in the rite of parting. The 7 kites represent the 7.
I took the liberty of coloring outside the lines when doing the insignia of the Animo Archon. As for the kite that honors the Geo Archon, one must follow the contract given right down to the last letter. These patterns are ancient, and you can also find them in the Golden House.
Ah, Paimon's heard that name before! Huh?
The design of this kite displays a firm grasp on the cyclicality and eternity so dear to the Electro Archon. These markings of tree and leaf pay due honor to wisdom and the passage of time. All this on a single kite. Truly astonishing. Justice flows across the surface of the waters. War rages like a flame. As does that which the Cryo Archon once... Yes. These details are masterfully done.
The compliments of a learned man truly are pleasant.
Well then, Granny Shan, I shall take these back with me. As for the payment...
Well, allow me.
Hey, it's Child!
No way. I was just passing through. I see Mr. Zhang Li's the same as ever. When paying, well, when getting others to pay for him, he neither looks at the price tag nor his wallet. He knows a great deal about money, and about the trials of the common man. He just doesn't consider poverty to be something that could ever happen to him. Or perhaps, you could say that he cannot imagine himself lacking money.
How has he not died of hunger yet?
Child, you are as fond of jokes as ever. Well then, since we've purchased our kites without incident, there's no need to take a break before moving to the next step in our preparations. The rite of parting requires helping hands as well as materials. We should be able to find some people near the harbor.
Oh, by the way, take this bag of money. You probably won't want to let Zhang Li do the bargaining, if you know what I mean. Seems I missed out on some interesting information. I suppose I'll just have to find a more opportune moment next time.
Try your luck betting on Jade?
Listen,
a toast.
Let
to
me
our
tell
success.
You how it is.
Hiring help? Sure. But let me just say first that I'm a reserve member of the Adventurers Guild. I take adventuring commissions, but I don't do anything clerical.
Adventure? Venturing into the mountains to capture a few crystal flies seems adventurous enough.
Eh? That's not hard. Almost a bit too easy for a reserve adventurer. Never mind. I'll only charge you 15,000 mora. What say you?
A most fair price.
A pleasure doing business with you.
Wanmin Restaurant.
Should I save this money or invest it?
A full day of odd jobs at Yujing Terrace. No problem. 25,000 per day. A fair trade, yes?
Whoa, that's expensive. Could you give us a bit of a discount on account of the whole Hero of Mondstadt thing?
Hero of Mondstadt? Never heard of them.
Well, you may never have heard of this hero, but it seems you've heard of Mora nonetheless. Thus, I will simply pay the whole sum.
Hey, that's a good price. Anyone would work for this much, Mora.
Overeaten.
Mm.
Oh, help? Sure. I, Tick, always put in 100% effort into everything I do. Of course, there'll be a premium if you want me to give 110%. So what's the job?
Let me see. We are still missing some wooden implements over at Yujing Terrace. They aren't uncommon objects, so I didn't make any special preparations for them.
No problem. That'll be 20,000 mora for a single trip. How does that sound?
Done.
This is all you got? Then no can do. Child? No. He's putting up the money? Still no. Wouldn't that mean I have to make two trips rather than one? How about this? Let's make a trade. I'll take what you're offering right now, and get me a single Chingson flower, and I'll consider that payment for a detour to find this child fellow. How does that sound?
Guess we've got no choice.
Have you brought the goods? Hey, that's pretty good. These things are pretty rare, and I have no idea where I'd find them. With this Chingson flower, I should be able to pacify my daughter tonight. I'll make sure the work is done before I return home.
There. Come and see these rare and precious curios.
Need another handsome sum today?
All finished then? Splendid. Any leftover cash is yours to keep. A favor for the Fatui should never go unrewarded.
You think you can buy us off with some loose change? No way! Paimon demands to know when the next payment is coming!
Well, how does this sound? You give me the information I need, and maybe I'll leave the Northland Bank's vaults open and unattended for half an hour.
What info do you need? Huh. Does that mean you know what he's after? You're right, Signora!
You both need to calm down. I don't know what's gotten into you. Just what is this about? The atmosphere got so tense all of a sudden.
Next, we need some everlasting incense. For this, we need to go to Boo Boo Pharmacy, the finest pharmacy in all of... Is everything okay?
Everything is fine. I was just informing them that they need not return the surplus mora. Now, if you'll excuse me, I must be going.
Paimon definitely felt like Child wasn't happy with us just now.
Thank you.
assistant. No, but it's not that. Not people have anything. Well, I think it's a bit nice. This isn't a
The reception is deserted, and it seems kinda spooky in here. Hello? Is anybody there?
Welcome to Boo Boo Pharmacy.
Huh? Did you hear that? Where did it come from?
The reception, it seems.
How about you go check it out, and bye my- Oh, there you are! But you can't even reach the counter! Ah, Paimon thinks you might be right! Look at the talisman on her forehead!
Welcome to Boo Boo Pharmacy. I am Chi-Chi. Once upon a time, Chi-Chi died. Then, Chi-Chi was saved by the Adepti. Now, Chi-Chi is a zombie.
Something like this would be unimaginable in Mondstadt.
Hello, little girl. Do you sell everlasting incense here?
Excuse me, sir. Did you bring your prescription?
I... Surely no prescription is needed to purchase everlasting incense. It's not a controlled substance.
Chi-Chi can get your medicine. But only if you show Chi-Chi your prescription. These are Chi-Chi's orders from Chi-Chi.
I'm afraid that she's probably right. It's to do with her orders. Zombies are limited to acting within the confines of their orders. And somehow in this case, the zombie issues her own orders to herself. My dear Chi-Chi, we didn't bring a prescription, I'm afraid. But we do hope that you can still help us find some everlasting incense.
Okay, then.
How did you manage that?
But Chi-Chi helps you. You help Chi-Chi. Only fair.
Since when do customers need to do favors for customer service staff?
Never mind. Just think of it as a peer-to-peer transaction. That way, everybody wins. Sometimes in Liyue, the art of the deal is simply about victory via mental gymnastics.
Go to Mount Tianheng, find the Guizhong Ballista, and hunt a cocoa goat. Please and thank you.
Guizhong Ballista. I have heard of this device before. It's a kind of crossbow turret, installed on Mount Qinhong by an adeptus in the distant past, an early mechanical device. Located in Qinhong Pass, it was designed to automatically fire at large monsters, protecting Liyue from external threats.
Mr. Zhang Li really knows Liyue inside out.
Apparently not quite. This is the first I have ever heard of the cocoa goat.
The cocoa goat is a legendary animal, an adeptabeast.
Did you want to add anything else, or...?
No, just that the cocoa goat is a legendary animal, an adeptabeast. What it looks like, don't know. Where to find it, don't know either. Where it came from, also don't know.
Very well then. Let's start by investigating near the Guizhong Ballista. Perhaps we will find some clues.
What the heck is a cocoa goat?
A chocolate goat. And stay back. Hello again.
don't want to. It tastes gross.
Let's put that there. Excuse me.
It's huge! Paimon can totally believe it took an Adeptus to build this. But how do you operate this thing?
That's
just think how much strength you would need.
It is currently inoperable in any case. This device is broken.
Aw, what? It broke?
After millennia of wear and tear, even Adepti contraptions are difficult to maintain.
Use your unlimited high society knowledge powers!
You almost make it sound like I'm some sort of bourgeois parasite whose only utility lies in providing quaint pieces of trivia on demand. That said, let me think for a moment. Ah, yes. Spare parts were made for the Guizhong Ballista when it was first built, in case it was damaged in battle. As I recall, there is a military supply post from that period somewhere inside the pass. If we can retrieve the spare parts from where they are stored, we may be able to repair the Guizhong Ballista. One just needs to understand the basic working principles of the device.
So, what you're saying is that you actually understand the working principles?
I have a smattering of knowledge on the topic. With the parts in hand, I could at least tinker with it. Ah, these parts look useful. One moment. I will try to repair the device. It is done. The Guizhong Ballista is more intricately designed than I thought.
Ooh! Now how do we turn it on?
It's easy enough. We simply need to do this. Look, it even has a scope.
Over here we have nothing. And over there, more nothing.
Hey, just what do you think you're doing? So you fixed up this turret because you're planning to do what exactly?
Not a turret, a Guizhong Ballista. Also, kindly state your name before you ask a question. It's just good manners.
Are you blind or something? You're looking at the leader of the treasure hoarders, old man. This area is supposed to be chock full of hidden treasures. but you can't get anywhere near them with this thing keeping watch. It might look like any other mechanical device, but trust me, it's got a mind of its own. Last time we approached the mountain, it nearly skewered one of our guys. A few of us risked our lives to disarm it, which amazingly we managed. And then we turn our backs for 2 seconds, and you've already gone and repaired it? The next thing you'll be repairing is your faces, and that's if you get out of this alive!
Tut tut. Vandalizing the legacy of an Adeptus for selfish gain. Disgraceful behavior. It is not we who need reprimanding, but you.
Like over here on the cutscene, my friend is down over. Stupid cutscene.
Windblade!
Let's spark things up a little. You're in for a little shock. Dig. Hup.
You can bully me!
to bully me? Duh. Windblade. 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 Can't handle your drink. Huh. Shake an ass, stir. Blade. lowlifes didn't know who they were messing with.
Troubling ourselves over this rabble is not worth the time. We should focus on our contract with Chi-Chi.
Oh, yeah, that! So we've got the Guizhong Ballista working, but where's our Coca Goat?
A search using the Guizhong Ballista revealed no significant life forms nearby, save for the usual wildlife. What's more, a contraption built using Adeptus technology should have no trouble detecting an Adeptabeast, as Chi-Chi put it.
Which means... Paimon wouldn't go that far. We did something positive, right?
We won't solve anything while standing here and racking our brains. Let's return to Boo Boo Pharmacy, explain that we could not find Coco Goat, and review our next step.
Good idea. We did our best, and that's what counts.
No one escapes my sights!
Just kept checking before the fire hit and the various things. Play one with a pot. Let's go. We can stay.
Thank you.
Forgive us. We were unable to fulfill our end of the contract. We found no trace of the Cocoa Goat Adeptabeast of which you speak.
What a disappointment. Don't worry about it. But I feel very disappointed.
Aw, poor Chi-Chi. Why does Paimon feel so guilty all of a sudden?
Cocoa goat milk is tasty. So tasty. Much better than normal goat milk. Only an Adeptabeast could make such tasty milk. I'm sorry. I have a poor memory. I cannot remember the name of the milk. That's why I wrote it down. Where did I put it? Ah, here. This is the name. coconut milk.
Huh?
I owe you both an apology. I hastily agreed to what appeared to be an equitable agreement with this zombie child, when perhaps I should have undertaken further due diligence.
Never mind, Zhongli. You didn't know. As the Liyue proverb goes, all things are random and... So how are you supposed to predict anything? Literally no one could have seen this coming.
Excuse me, everyone. Did Chi-Chi say a bad thing?
Oh, sorry, but Paimon's gonna leave the job of shattering this poor kiddo's world to you.
No. Impossible.
Seems Chi-Chi took this pretty hard.
Someone learnt a valuable life lesson today, then. Thank you all for looking after my little Chi-Chi.
Might I ask who?
Ah, how rude of me. I'm Baiju, boss of the Boo Boo Pharmacy.
I thought Chi-Chi was the boss. Turns out it's some wacko who wears medicinal ingredients around his neck.
What a sorry state of affairs. This little mascot is even more of a simpleton than Chi-Chi.
Ah! The medicine... the snake is speaking!
I prefer to stay silent, but faced with strangers, I must speak, lest you mistake me for an escapee from the medicine cabinet, for I am a living, breathing serpent!
Don't mind Chengsheng. She's a good girl, really. As for you three, communal chaos causing with Chi-Chi aside, what business brings you here?
Do you sell everlasting incense in this fine establishment?
Everlasting incense? Why, of course we do.
Whew, at last. Things are finally starting to come together.
3 million mora. Top quality. Guaranteed.
Too bad the Chi-Sing have taken it over for now. Security will be tighter than usual.
3 million. An innocuous number in and of itself. Though practically speaking, it could be a hard sum to come by.
It's a crazy number. We'd never be able to make that much mora. And as for Mr. Zhongli, he's around 3 million short.
This is correct.
Is this the part where we go crawling back to child?
Coco goat! Coco goat! My sides hurt. Oh my goodness, I cannot believe you fell for that.
Hey, less laughter, more sympathy!
I'm almost in tears over here. Thank you. That was the best laugh I've had in a long time. In return, I'm more than happy to sort out this mess you've managed to get yourselves into. Excuse me, sir. Dr. Baiju, isn't it? Truly honored. I'm Child, one of the Fatui Harbingers. Forgive my audacity, but I see a great many opportunities for us to collaborate in the future. If Boo Boo Pharmacy needed a stable supply of, say, coconut milk, the Fatui could help by setting up a robust and speedy distribution network.
Strange. I knew the Fatui infiltrated businesses with seductive deals, but so much fuss over coconut milk?
Coconut milk. Baiju, quick. Chi-Chi wants coconut milk.
Ah, yes, of course, Chi-Chi. Anything you want. Thank you, Child. I look forward to a successful collaboration in the future. I can give you a discount on that everlasting incense, too. Let's say 2,990,000 mora.
That's like zero difference from 3 million!
2,990,000. Also an innocuous number in and of itself, though practically speaking, it is a whole 10,000 less than the original sum of 3 million. Well, now that this is settled, we must head back to Yujing Terrace. Mr. Child, Dr. Baiju, little Miss Chi-Chi, see you soon.
Ah, that lot is an absolute riot. Honestly, I can't remember the last time I laughed so hard. So, you've been eavesdropping, I hope. What have I missed?
Yes, Master Child. We spoke of the Qixing taking the Golden House.
Well, well, well. Ningguang and her Qixing cronies. What else would they be hiding in the Golden House, if not the Exuvia? I apologize, but I warned you, didn't I? As the old Liyue saying goes, the walls have ears.
What an odd exchange we've had. Well, I look forward to your patronage in the future as well.
That sound is the laughter of a man who's found new people to fleece. Consider yourselves warned.
This is good. There will be coconut milk from now on. Yes, it's good.
What an odd exchange we've had. Well, I look forward to your patronage in the future as well.
That sound is the laughter of a man who's found new people to fleece. Consider yourself warned.
Hello.
Well, as it stands, we've hired helpers, and we've acquired the everlasting incense. The completion of our preparations is not far off.
Whew! Finally!
Well, traveler, have you gained anything from our adventure so far? Odd? Which is it, I wonder? The questions that such travels raise are ever so complicated. Well, I'll leave you to ruminate over it yourself. As to remuneration for your help, I've decided to treat you to a meal. Yes, don't worry. I will remember to bring the mora this time. Tonight, I shall take you both to an old hole in the wall, praised throughout Lyra.
Restaurant?
Indeed. Let us meet near the harbor at third round knockout.
Should I save this money?
Try something new at the
Wan
Min restaurant.
Listen, let me tell you.
Astra Abyssosk. Welcome to the Adventurers Guild.
Okay.
Ad Astra.
Another handsome sum today.
Curios.
A toast to our success.
Listen, let me tell you how it is.
Ah, you're here. There's no need to order. I've already done so. Third round knockout is not for lightweights, like those taverns in Mondstadt. Here, the owner does not take such unorthodox orders as fruit juice. I ordered some wine-fermented sweet rice balls for you, if that counts.
If it is to your liking, dear customers, I shall continue the tale of Lady Ningguan's Jade Chamber.
Great atmosphere!
Besides fine wine, the excellent ambiance is the reason why this place is so well loved. But when I say ambiance, I refer to a different sort from the one the Teyvat travel guide uses to judge other establishments.
As you all know, high above the land of Liyue. Is a pavilion in the clouds, a palace in the mist. What does it mean to have all-seeing eyes? This, my friends, Lady Ningguan's masterwork that bridges earth and sky. Imagine, the weather is clear, and you gaze down from the deck on the world below. Behold, the glorious sights of Liyue Harbor, stretching out far and wide. They say that when Lady Ningguan ponders important affairs, she retreats to her jade chamber with none. But her three closest confidants in tow. Why brings she these trusted three to sift through sources, dig through documents, looking for information? Piece by piece, facts and figures paint a picture on the walls of the chamber. But before the wall is filled, Lady Ningguang's mind is made up. Having made her call, she has every last document shredded, and whoosh, she scatters the shavings out her window. Ah, look at them, how they billow in the wind like a sudden swirling blizzard. As the fragments fall, traces of text flicker before the eyes of the merchants of Liyuan, like ink stains in white snow. The saying goes, the rarest treasures in the land are the words brought by the paper snow. For the words of the Tianchuan have the power to move mountains, and all throughout the land know it. These are but scraps of paper, and yet they guide Lady Ningguang's hand. Such is their value. Merely grasping one or two of them will surely gift you a fragment of her wisdom. Enough to stay a step or two ahead of your peers.
Tianchuan Ningguang. Feels like we're hearing this name a lot. Liyue locals talk about her. The Fatui hate her. She's most likely the one who hid the Exuvia, and we saw her at the Rite of Dissension. Huh. Paimon wonders what sort of person she is.
At last I have found you. You who returned from Juayun Karst.
Who's there?
Wait, I am not with the Millilith, nor am I here to claim your bounty. However, I am an emissary of the Liyue Qixing. My name is Ganyu, secretary at the Yuahai Pavilion, and I have come specifically to meet you. Well, in concrete terms, I am the corporate secretary for the Qixing. At the moment, I am serving as Lady Ningguang's special.
Sorry.
Ningguang sent you? We were literally just talking about her.
My apologies, you who have returned from Jiayun Karst. I am duty bound and cannot extend my courtesy to you in full. But I have with me a letter from Lady Ningguang. She extends a formal invitation to you in her capacity as Tianchuan. She invites you to her palace in the sky.
An official invitation?
Lady Ningguang said this. Invite her to come here. I wish to meet her. At the Jade Chamber, together we shall snip every one of these entwining dark threads.
The emissary who called herself Ganyu just disappeared. But we've received an invitation from the Liyue Qixing. Paimon still can't believe it. We'll be meeting people that have way more Paimon could ever count. We should be on our best manners.
An invitation to visit the Jade Chamber is a rare honor indeed. You'd best be on your way now. But don't forget about the rite of parting. Once you've finished at the Jade Chamber, meet me at Dihua Marsh.
Don't worry, we won't forget. Dihua Marsh. We'll see you there!
A toast to our success!
Made another handsome sum today.
Come, come and see these rare and precious curios.
to our success.
Made another handsome sum today?
Ho there. Come. Come and see these rare and precious curios.
Ningguang. Ganyu. I wonder where we will find them amid these dark tides.
Listen, let me tell you how it is. Today.
Ho there, come, come and see these rare and precious curios.
Funny.
Thank you.
Windblade.
Look at you, boozehound!
Be gone!
second answer!
Mind Blade!
All your travel essentials right here.
Anfeng's Ironmongers, here to serve.
Thank you.
need to be so hurtful.
Thank you.
Waiting for you. I just happened to be resting.
Thank you.
I'm here.
Auto reconfiguration is an essential function.
Let's go, let's go! Waiting for you. I just happened to be resting.
Should I save
Try this? Something?
Cheap and tasty chop suey.
Try something new at the Wanmin restaurant.
I'm here.
Jewelry's out of stock, but we have some new items in.
Sweet cuisine is inedible.
But you didn't let me finish.
But
are supposed to come true at Lantern, right? Aren't they?
Take a seat.
I'm sure they'd sell well in Snezhnaya.
Lantern's so big. Building materials.
My
thank you.